So we are continuing with our numericals on impact of jet on moving plates. Okay, we saw two problems. We solved two problems. Now we'll solve the third problem. Okay, the third problem says a jet of water 60 millimeter in diameter strikes a curved vane or plate at its center with a velocity of 18 meter per second. The curved vane is moving with a velocity of 6 meter per second in the direction of jet. The jet is deflected through an angle of 165 degree. Assuming the plate to be smooth, find first thrust on the plate, second power of the jet, and third efficiency of the jet. Now we'll see the question in detail. What does it say? There is a jet of water of 60 millimeter diameter. Okay, it strikes a curved plate at its center with a velocity of 18 meter per second. Okay, so the jet is striking the curved plate at the center. Okay, the velocity of the plate, capital V, is 18 meter per second, and the velocity of the plate, the moving curved plate or vane, is small u, that is 6 meter per second. The jet is deflected through an angle of 165 degree. So, assuming the plate to be smooth, find out first thrust on the plate in the direction of jet, that is the force on the plate, second power of the jet, and third efficiency of the jet. Okay, thrust means the force on the plate. First, okay, we'll see the diagram. This is the direction of jet. Okay, it is traveling in the x direction. The velocity of the jet is capital V. Okay, this is the curved plate and the jet strikes the plate at the center. Now after striking the plate, okay, the jet gets deflected through 165 degrees. Okay, the jet gets deflected through 165 degrees. This is the angle theta, which is the angle between the horizontal and the tangent drawn to the curved plate. Okay, now if the jet strikes the plate with a velocity V, capital V, and if we assume that there is no loss in energy and the curved plate is smooth, then the jet will come out with a velocity capital V. Okay, now this jet which comes out with velocity V, it is coming out at an inclined angle. That inclined angle is theta. Okay, that is the jet V at the outlet makes an angle theta with the horizontal. Now this velocity will have two components, one in the y direction, one in the x direction. In the x direction the component is cos component, that is V cos theta, and in the y direction it is sin component, that is V sin theta. Okay, so we'll solve the problem. This is an example of impact of jet on moving curved plate when the jet strikes the plate at center. We have seen that in the diagram in the last slide. Now given values are diameter of the jet 0.06 meter or 60 millimeters. From that we can find out area, which is pi by 4 into d square. So the area of the jet is 0.002827 meter square. Velocity of the jet is capital V, 18 meter per second. Velocity of the vane or the plate is small u, 6 meter per second. Angle of deflection of jet is 165 degrees. But angle of deflection of jet is also theta minus, 180 minus theta degree. So 165 degree is equal to theta minus 180 minus theta degree. So theta is equal to 180 degree minus 165 degree. So our value of theta is 15 degree. That is, okay, this theta, it is 15 degree. Okay, so first we will find out the thrust on the plate in the direction of jet, that is Fx, force in the x direction. This is the formula for force exerted by the jet on the plate when the jet strikes at the center of the moving plate. Okay, it is rho a v minus u whole bracket square 1 plus cos theta, where rho is 1000, area we have found out 0.002827, velocity of the jet is 18 meter per second and velocity of the plate is 6 meter per second and theta is 15 degree. So force in the x direction is 800.3 newtons. Second, power of the jet. For finding out the power of the jet, first we will find out the work done per second by the jet. It is nothing but the force exerted by the jet on the plate in the direction of jet, that is x direction. So the force will be Fx. We know its value, it is 800.3 newtons multiplied by velocity of the plate small u. It is 6 meter per second. Okay. So the answer is 4801.8 newton meter per second. This is the work done per second by the jet. So this, it can be converted into 4801.8 watt. Newton meter per second is nothing but watt. Okay. Now, power of the jet is nothing but 4801.8 watt, or we can say it is 4.8 kilowatts. Okay. Third, we will find out the efficiency of the jet. Okay. This is the third point. So efficiency is work done per second upon kinetic energy of jet in motion. Work done per second is the output, kinetic energy of jet is the input. Now, work done per second, we have found out the answer in the last slide. The kinetic energy of jet formula is half mv square, where m is rho into a into v. That is, mass of the jet is density of the jet into area of the jet into velocity of the jet. Okay, it is given here. So, kinetic energy of the jet, okay, rho, we know the value. A value of the area we know, and value of the velocity also we know. So kinetic energy of the jet, it is 8243.5 newton meter per second. Okay, so the efficiency is work done per second, that is 4801.8 divided by kinetic energy, which is 8243.5. so efficiency of the jet is 0.5825 or 58.25%. So we have finished the third problem. Now we'll see the fourth problem. It is a jet of water 80 millimeter diameter and having a velocity of 20 meter per second impinges at the center of a hemispherical vane. The linear velocity of the vane is 10 meter per second in the direction of jet. Find the force exerted on the vane. How the force would change if the jet impinges on a series of vanes attached to the circumference of field? So I'll explain the question. The jet of water has a diameter of 80 millimeter and it has a velocity of 20 meter per second, and it strikes, impinges means it strikes at the center of a hemispherical vane. Okay, now this is an example of hemispherical vane. Okay, in this, the jet of water enters the plate. This is the jet of water. It enters the plate in the x direction, and due to the plate being hemispherical, it leaves the jet also in the x direction. Okay, so the linear velocity of the vane is 10 meter per second. Okay, that is u, velocity of the plate, it is 10 meter per second. Find the force exerted on the vane, that is on the plate, by the jet. How will this force change if the jet impinges on a series of vanes attached to the circumference of a wheel? That means, how would this force change if the jet is to impinge on a series of curved plates attached to the periphery of wheel? Okay, so this is an example of impact of jet on a series of curved vanes mounted on the periphery of wheel. Okay, now first we'll find out the force on a single curved vane, then we'll find out the force on the complete wheel, that is the wheel consisting of a number of curved vanes. Okay, given diameter, area, velocity, capital V, that is velocity of jet 20 meter per second, velocity of vane 10 meter per second. Okay. Now, when the jet strikes at the center of a moving plate or a moving vane, it strikes with an effective velocity V minus U that we know. Okay. So, force exerted on a single vane, formula it is given here, F is equal to rho A bracket V minus U whole bracket square 1 plus cos theta. This formula is of impact of jet on a moving curved plate when the jet strikes at the center. Okay, this formula is of that example. So, but for a hemispherical vane, theta is equal to 0. Okay, we have seen in the last slide. Okay, as this is a hemispherical vane or a plate, the velocity will come out of this plate at the outlet having angle 0 with the horizontal. It will come out in a horizontal direction. So here theta will be, that is, theta is nothing but the angle made by the velocity at the outlet with respect to the horizontal. It is 0 degree. So this will be cos 0. So 1 plus cos 0. Cos 0 is 1, so it is 1 plus 1. So the formula becomes 2 rho A into V minus U whole bracket square. We know the value of rho, we know the value of A, and we know the value of V and U. So the answer, force exerted on a single vane is F is equal to 1005.2 newtons. Okay. Now, second, if that vane is attached to the periphery of a wheel which consists of a number of such curved vanes, then the entire fluid mass issuing from the jet will be rho A V. Okay. Now, in the previous example, when the jet was striking a single plate, the formula was V minus U. It was striking with an effective velocity V minus U. Now, when the jet will strike a number of curved vanes, the formula is rho A into V. So the velocity will be only V, not V minus U. Okay. Because in the case of a series of vanes, the jet will keep on continuously striking a number of curved vanes. So it will always be striking with a velocity V. Okay. So in this case, the force exerted by the jet on the vane system will be F is equal to rho A V into V minus U 1 plus cos theta. This is the formula for force exerted on a series of curved vanes. You can see the formula. Here theta is equal to 0 degree. So again, rho A V into bracket V minus U into 1 plus cos 0, where cos 0 is 1. Okay. So 1 plus 1 again. 2 rho A V into bracket V minus U. Okay, this formula. Rho is 1000, area is 0.005026, velocity of the jet is 20, and velocity of the plate is 10 meter per second. So the answer is F is equal to 2010.4 newton. When the force is exerted by the jet on series of vane or a vane system, the force is 2010.4 newton, and when the force is exerted on a single plate, the answer is 1005.2 newton, and when the force is exerted on a series of vane, the answer is 2010.4 newton. Okay. Thank you.